The governor of Anambra State, Chief Willie Obiano, is increasingly walking his talk on stimulating, growing, and entrenching food security in Anambra State. Chief Obiano's advocacy and avowals for agri-revolution have been made real by the policies and acts of his government, which have provoked an influx of private and public-private investment of different sizes in farming and agro-allied ventures in Anambra. Rice, cassava, maize, yam, tomato, and poultry are at the forefront of the products which improve production in quantity and quality, pronounces Governor Obiano's pivotal and catalytic roles in the remarkable transformation in the state agriculture sector.
When I look at the trends in our national economy, I feel justified in my decision to make agriculture the number one pillar of my economic blueprint. Agriculture is becoming increasingly important in Nigeria, and we must continue to push ourselves harder to surpass the targets we have set for ourselves in the sector. It is in the pursuit of this that we have set our sights on deepening our efforts to mechanize agriculture in the state. Nearby, I personally believe that the farm of the future must fulfill three important promises. It must feed the people. It must protect the environment, and it must offer a healthy return to investment. I have no doubt that Indian Anambra will rise to the occasion by coming to agriculture in a much larger way to help us sustain the momentum we have built in this sector.
The revolution witnessed in rice farming and milling in Anambra about the past 5 years of Chief Obiano's administration has placed the state on a ranking pedestal, not only as one with the capacity to erase the product deficit in Nigeria's market, but as a state that is capable of making rice a major foreign exchange earner via the product export.
Agriculture is His Excellency's first pillar, and he's been pumping so much money into developing that subtech sector. Before he came in 2014, the rice production was at a very low ebb of about 80,000 metric tons, but presently we are doing 345,000 metric tons with hope, with after the season, to get to 400,000 metric tons in the rice.
A close survey of the unprecedented shift in the rice farming and milling status of Anambra State easily locates the hands of Chief Obiano. First, in the establishment of Anambra State Investment Promotion and Protection Agency, ANSIPA, an arm of the state government statutorily designed to facilitate the siting of viable and bankable investments in Anambra geo-economic space. Secondly, Anambra Small Business Agency, ASBA, an ancillary organ of the state government instituted by Chief Obiano to assist in funding and supervising budding and fledging enterprises. These bodies, in addition to the safety the state government guarantees investors and everyone in the state, have largely sustained the blossoming of rice production in Anambra State.
Like everything in life, you needed a facilitator. Let me say, outside of God Almighty, I will give the credit of the success of this farm to the governor of Anambra State, Chief Willie Obiano. When he called the investors forum, you know, and called the top guys of Anambra State and share his view and seven cardinal points of economic revolution in Anambra State, while he was talking, he mentioned agriculture. So I just pinched myself. I said, wait a minute. So during question and answer, I raised up my hand. I said, you really mean you are committed to do this? He said yes, that he believed that that is a way to create job in the state. The truth is that you can't have economic development without security in the state. The first attraction was that I believe Anambra State was then safe again, because some years before then, nobody come here and sleep overnight. So he tackled security to reinforce confidence in the mind of the citizenry. And people like us who have been yearning within ourselves saw an opportunity and capitalized on it. And to the glory of God, like I said, it was a dream come true.
The recent opening of the fully automated Koscharis rice farms drew the attention of the entire agricultural establishment in Nigeria to Anambra State. The 40,000 metric tons per year rice mill is a great example of what Anambra State can become if her enterprising indigents finally decide to look homewards and change the narrative.
I would like to sincerely thank the Almighty God, without whom it would not have been possible for us to be here today. The second thanks will go to His Excellency Governor Mother Projukun Obiano, who made all of this possible. God used people to make things happen. Okay, there's no investment that will thrive without security. So you need to create a friendly atmosphere that investors will consider safe, because you want to make money, but the money you are making is no more important than your life.
I salute His Excellency Governor Willie Obiano, the Executive Governor of Anambra State, for creating the environment which enabled Koscharis Farms Limited to thrive and thereby making this project a reality today. And of course, today, everybody knows in Nigeria that because of the policies that the governor himself put in place towards ridding the state of criminality and banditry, that this state is one of the safest states in Nigeria today.
The amazing resuscitation of the huge rice mill at Umumbo, a federal government venture which suffered long period of abandonment and went moribund, but which Governor Obiano successfully negotiated his concession to Anambra State Government, is most gratifying in a public-private partnership initiative between the state government and Joseph Agro Group. Josan Rice Ventures was commissioned to awaken the comatose giant mill. Given the enormity of the degradation of the facility, most observers thought the commission dead on arrival. But the naysayers were wrong after all.
We got the CFO of this place here, that was in 2018. This used to be the former largest rice mill in the whole nation. Unfortunately, for reasons that I can't explain, successive governments have tried to resuscitate this mill, but it's never worked. And we took up the challenge and were able to bring back this mill fully to life. So the mill is 100% working now.
The giant Mumbo mill became operational within an incredible short space of time. This gargantuan feat, in addition to the success of Joson Pilot Rice Production Scheme, which was earlier inaugurated at Ufuma in 2014, lends credence to Governor Obiano's strategic thinking as an acclaimed accountant and a professional investment banker.
This is a very important day for Umumbo, for my administration, and for our dear Anambra State. Nibai, this event is a very crucial chapter in the agricultural narrative of Anambra State. The commissioning of this farm rice mill today should inspire pride in all of us. In much the same way, the laying of the foundation stone of the irrigation community water scheme in Ayame local government area should reassure us all that my administration has maintained a steady focus on agriculture. This rice mill was abandoned for 28 years, but this one has brought it back to life in partnership with Anambra State Government. Indeed, Josan Integrated Rice Farms has shown a great ambition since they signed an MOU with my administration. They are presently cultivating 321 hectares of land at Ufuma, in Orumba North, and planning to acquire 5,000 more hectares at Umumbo here.
Currently, the mill has an input of 80,000 metric tons of paddies, because that's normally how you judge mills, and then has an output of 50,000 tons per year. However, we have put in two other small mills here, so there's also been an expansion drive, and we presume that in about the next month, this mill would have an input of about 100,000 tons.
Oh, 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 oh
The Stein Group at Amici is among the league of beneficiaries who leverage on the governor's expertise in investment and the willingness of ASBA to recapitalize production ventures under the threat of grounding. The state government intervenes in diverse ways to ensure improved rice production. It interfaces between the farmers and organization on one hand and government in sourcing and managing funds and requisite technical know-how for improved rice farming. This informs the participation of the federal government of Nigeria, NISRAL, IFAD, FADAMA, and other development partners whose deployment in the state is because the state government is responsive in meeting its counterpart funding and other relevant terms.
I've gained a lot from the inputs. Those inputs are such as fertilizer, herbicides, seeds. So while they bring input for us, we pay 50%, and value chain we pay 50%.
The farmers say I'm making a lot of money this year. 1 hectare gives all the farmers a profit of 700,000 naira. Average of 700,000 naira. So because of that, the farmers are very happy. And then we are aware that if it continues like that, before long, farmers will be among the people we will be talking of in the society.
The government hires and leases equipment to farmers. It provides them improved seed. It even buys up huge quantities of the product from the mills as occasions demand.
As you are well aware, the Z Seed is a company which is doing a seed multiplication for the ministry. For, in fact, for the state government, there's an MOU signed with the ministry that all the seed he produces will be bought over by the ministry under our procurement process, so that we use it now to distribute to our farmers to produce the paddy rice that will be sent to the mills, because all the investors would want to have breeder seeds that they are going to use and to plant in their farms. Qatari has imported also some varieties of new seeds which we have already evaluated and found to be okay, which is already developing. So Z-Seed is doing so well for us. When those crops are harvested, they will be for the ministry to uptake. We are now the uptakers, which we use now to distribute to other farmers that will produce the seeds, they produce the paddy for the mills.
The way they help us is cannot be overemphasized. From 2015 till now, I can say that the state government made me to be a millionaire, because before then, to sell rice is very difficult for us. But since our governor started buying rice from us, especially during Christmas time, to give to the civil servant, I'm sure we are making very, very big profit from it. And we don't face a challenge of a bad market again.
The government encourages the outgrowers and off-taker scheme in the value chain plan, wherein smaller farmers are encouraged by big players by way of supplying them seeds and other ancillary aids in materials and services and buying up their paddles at the end of the day.
There are some farmers I do buy from through the value chain agro scheme. Actually, during farming season, we do support them by giving them the inputs and small little cash. So in turn, we will buy the rice from them by minusing the amount we spend for them, and they pay them the remaining one cash.
In their different capacities, Udoka Rice Processing Group at Omo, Nedema Integrated Rice Mill Omo, Wisdom Rice Mill Oka, and the mega mill run by Stein Rice Mill Amici, Joseon Rice Mills at Umumbo and Ufuma, as representational of the ventures in the rice processing industry who have latched onto Governor Willie Obiano's vision to grow rice beyond the immediate needs of the Anambra and Nigeria and create jobs and wealth therefrom. Driven by the passion to improve the lot of rice production and milling, Chief Obiano ensured the transmission of electricity from Oji River Power Station in Enugu State to Ufuma, where Joseon has one of its rice farms and mills.
The government has really been very good, like in Ufuma. The government was able to bring power to Ufuma. And it came all the way from another state, which is Enugu State, from Oji River, to be very precise. And the government spent about 260 million naira on it. So these are all other things that the government does to build roads, to build power, to help with irrigation, and then to also help the farmers. So even if the government is not funding JOSAM, there are many things the government does to be able to create an enabling environment for people like JOSAM and others to now come in.
The state government provides land as its primary equity in the holdings of majority of the big farms in the rice industry. The state government is increasingly constructing access roads to the difficult terrains where most of the rice ventures are sited. It is equally facilitating extensive irrigation projects to provide sufficient water for the vast span of arable rice fields around the Umumbo-Omo axis.
To the glory of God, the foundation stone laying of Anambra Water and Irrigation Project by His Excellency Nabumo Wole Obiano this day, 11th February 2019, to the glory of God.
I want to use this opportunity to thank the Excellency for the letter I wrote to AFDB, indicating your interest for this project. It also helped us in packaging the project and the interest of the African Development Bank on the project. And also payment of counterpart fund. I won't forget that one. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. I must say that we've been working tirelessly with Honorable Commissioner and the Sana Group to come up with alternative design, which will include dropping water for the host communities, because it's part of the social impact of the project. So we have agreed on that. So most likely because the environmental impact assessment has shown that we need to drop water for the host communities. So that's why the project may take a little time, but we'll brief you as we move on. But within the 6 months, you'll come and flag it off.
If this was the rainy season now, you would see about 7,000 farmers working on this land. Unfortunately, due to the dry season, you do not see farmers here. And this is one thing that the government of Anambra State has taken upon itself to fix. So the whole idea is to have water all year round, and that would enable us to have paddies all year round.
With Governor Willie Obiano's unending innovative approaches to expanded rice production and milling in Anambra State, it is obvious that the popularity and availability of the Anambra rice brand, which he birthed as part of the early signs of his ingenious administrative trait, will endure and continue to soar beyond his reign as the state governor.
Projections show that by 2050, we would have 400 million people. So that explains the explosive growth and demand of rice. It's more about, can you produce enough rice? The market is there. There are people that sell, there are people that buy, there are people that trade with it. And it's something that goes faster than production. So the major thing is really to be able to increase production.
The efforts to encourage more people to go into farming have also yielded tremendous results, as there are currently 115,000 farmers and 2,700 cooperative societies.
His Excellency is also looking at other sub-sectors which can improve our gains in the agricultural sector. You are well aware of his passion to drive the FIBO production. So we are getting statistical information on where the ranches can be situated, what are the adaptability of the cows to those areas, especially, you know, the local cow we are trying to develop. So we are coming up with that. Very soon we'll come up with a very standard policy. Also, we are looking at other areas that can diversify the economy of the state with respect to youth and women empowerment, looking at apiculture, that is honeybee production. Apart from the honey we use as a substitute to sugar, honeybee has a lot of side products that can give youth and women a lot of money in their pocket aside from the honey. So we'll be launching an Happy Expo very soon, where all the honey producers in the state will come with whatever they're doing, and then we train local government by local government the youth that we're going to use in setting up sub-villages, apiculture villages in all the local governments. Then we'll have a central processing line where all the extractors, the cleaning facilities will be located. An investor or an off-taker will be centrally located, where he pulls up all these honey cleans it, processes it, and then bottles it in partnership with Anambra Label, because Anambra honey has already been registered as a brand name. Now, we have recently received a very keen interest in sweet potato production. There's an investor who has approached us. He has imported a $10 million worth of equipment for processing of sweet potato, transferring it to nodules and all that, which is going to both for local market and for export. So we are sourcing 10,000 registered farmers that will meet this request. So our people are also under the community farm development in the field, enumerating the cooperative men and women that will form the nucleus of these sweet potato producers. It's a new product as it were into the Anambra value chain. We want to now go into commercial sweet potato production, which is a major curb. The good thing about this one is that the off-taker is already waiting for the product. So we are doing all these extended programs to increase the volume of agricultural potentials in the state with what His Excellency has already achieved in the rice subsector.
Obiano's forays in this sector began with the setting up of a special committee headed by a renowned agronomist known as Professor Chukwuemeka Omaliko. The committee was mandated to conduct a comprehensive research on soil types across Anambra State to determine which crop was suitable for which soil and location. The committee's findings revealed that rice, cassava, yam, tomatoes, and vegetables could be grown in commercial quantities in Ayamelum, Anambra East and West, Obaru, Ihiala, and Orumba South and North. And with this knowledge, the government went into partnerships with major agro investors like Chelsea Farms and other investors in the agro-allied sector.
Chelsea Farm is an initiative of Obiano administration. Initially, we had gone to Kogi to go and acquire 10,000 hectares of land. But when we had Obiano asking Anambra indigenes to think home, and indeed to come home and grow the local economy, we decided to join the bandwagon, not knowing that it was serious. Because I've seen governors in the past who were jokers, who would come and say something and indeed mean something else. So we approached an establishment set up by Obiano administration called ANSIPA. And I was shocked that Obiano is very serious. And then they were able to show me a location. I love it. It's heavenly. And having given allocated that to us, immediately we swung into action. We have about 156 people working in this farm.
Okay.
And we are cultivating 700 hectares of the cassava that we have cleared. Mm-hmm. Now, we are also cultivating the rice in about 400 hectares. The facilities we are building now for frost processing is higher than what we can grow in our own farm. We can process 50 tons of cassava per hour. So with that kind of capacity, we cannot grow it in our farm. But what it will afford us is that it will afford us opportunity of being the off-taker of all the neighborhood. That's I'm talking of the entire Anambra North, then some Kogi axis and Enugu axis. So we will now train them on how to cultivate. And when they cultivate, they bring, we buy. Our target is to develop human resources. A man is a resource based on what he can produce, not how fine he looks. The die is cast. There's no going back. So the big agri farm that you hear only in your ears without seeing it, is already starting in Anambra.
On the other hand, our vegetable farmers are doing just fine. Orca-based Grafil Nigeria Limited has been exporting vegetables from Anambra to the US for quite some time now.
2015, that's when we began to explore the opportunities there are. Following the concerted efforts of our governor, Dr. Willie Obiano, to encourage agricultural activity, particularly export of vegetables, we underwent some of the trainings they brought people from abroad to give interested actors on health and safety measures and ways to condition and preserve vegetables and make them exportable. And initially, we were moving our products from orca to Lagos. It was in Lagos we were loading them into reefer containers. And to do that, you need a refrigerated truck. So I used to check the reefer trucks provided by Anambra State government, move the cargo to Lagos, and in Lagos, we now transload into the reefer container for onward exports. Yes, so Anambra State, certainly under Willie Obiano, you know, has done so much to encourage the exports of agri products.
There's a lot of interest in Anambra. People are coming to understudy what Anambra has been doing in terms of agricultural development. And we are not renting on our own. We are trying to develop more programs that will upscale what we are doing. We are trying also to be mindful of the quality assurance, so that whatever that does not meet the market demand, that the market quality demand of the ministry will be taken off the shelf. And a lot of awareness is being created among the market women and the market men who are doing all these transactions to guarantee them that the support of the ministry is with them to make sure that whatever is coming to the system is quality assured.
This hope is upheld by the unequivocal faith the operatives in the thriving rice industry express in the efficacy of Chief Obiano's practical approach towards instituting them as viable employers of labor and successful entrepreneurs.
With all our hearts, we pray and ask, God bless Anambra, God bless the shining light that we bear. We're the only ones to make a brighter the old.